Welcome to Kids Church today. My name is Grace and this is my friend Theo, and we're so glad we get to hang out with you.
We are following alongside the themes of glory in Romans and wanted to continue our series on Easter and celebrate Ascension. Yay! Jesus is risen.
Jesus died on the cross for us and he rose again. And we're actually going to continue that story today, Ascension Sunday. But hold on, we're getting way ahead of ourselves. I'll explain that in a minute.
But first, Star of the Week.
Every week, we celebrate a kid who is doing awesome things and being, just in general, a pretty awesome person. So this week, we are going to announce who gets this fancy Nancy certificate, as well as a gift that always tastes pretty good. Okay, ready? We're going to do a drum roll. One, two, three. This week's Star of the Week is... Nora. Congratulations, Nora. You are this week's Star of the Week, which means you get this and a gift that tastes really good. Might have some candy in it. Just saying. Now, for those of you who are seasoned veterans, you know the drill. It is now time for worship. Isn't that right, Theo? Yes, it is. I will be right back. I know it's a little strange, right? But here are my raisins and they are ready to party. Always gotta test it first to make sure it tastes good. Yep, you passed the taste test. Mmm, yummy. So I have a bunch of raisins here. Oh, and they're all kind of stuck together. But these are all raisins and I'm sure you've seen them before, but do you know what raisins used to be? You're right, they used to be grapes. So each one of these raisins used to be a grape. So now they look a little shriveled. They're a little wrinkly, but boy, do they taste really good. So I'm gonna take my raisins and I'm gonna take my glass. And I have this fancy Nancy glass of, ooh, hello. The raisin stuck between my finger. And I'm gonna take this fancy Nancy bottle. Oh, okay, listen to this, listen. Nice. Whoa, do you hear the bubbles? All right, and I'm gonna pour some of my drink in here. So, you know, gotta make sure you test it. Yep, pretty good. And now let's roll up our sleeves. Let's grab. Okay, so I'm gonna take some raisins, and you know, they look a little wrinkly, but let's see if they wanna dance today. Okay, let's drop some in. Well, they're really floating around, aren't they? Whoa, do you see that? Our raisins are dancing. That's so cool. Look at them go whoop, whoop, all the way back up. Whoop, 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 whoop. So you're thinking, Grace, why are we looking at raisins dance? You know, that's pretty cute and all, but why does it matter that they're dancing? So the reason we're watching these raisins is because we're learning about a word, ascend. Ascend means something goes up, like an elevator or like our raisins. And in our lesson today, we're looking at the last time Jesus was on earth. And he had one final special meeting with them. So we're gonna look at a story video to find out what exactly happened on Jesus's last day on earth. Let's watch.
God is with us. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Jesus is the Savior of the world and the Son of God. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles, like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
But some people did not like what Jesus was doing. And they put him to death. He died on a cross and was buried in a tomb. For 3 days, Jesus's body laid in that tomb, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body, found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. For he was risen. He was alive.
Woo-hoo!
Huh? Hey-o!
Ah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. Jesus told his disciples that he did all the things that God had told everyone that he would do, and the disciples understood what he was saying.
Yep, that makes sense.
He told them that he would send the Holy Spirit, just as God had promised to be their helper.
Sounds good.
After Jesus had spent 40 days with the disciples and appeared to many people, he led the disciples to a place called Bethany. Jesus blessed the disciples and told them to go out and tell the whole world about him and the good news of forgiveness and make disciples of them. Then he said, "Be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Then Jesus was taken into heaven to sit at the right hand of God. Not long after that, the Holy Spirit did come to the disciples to be their helper. The disciples knew that God would truly be with them always. And the Holy Spirit is still with us today, for Jesus promised that he would be with us to the end of the age, and he is.
Wow, they're still going, look at that. Have you ever had a balloon that was not filled with air, but was filled with helium? And when you let it go, it rose up, right? It ascended. Just like Theo, he was here and now he's ascended. Oh wow, you made it all the way to the top. Nice. The disciples were looking and like, whoa, is that Jesus going up into the sky? And they were kind of sad because, well, who knows when Jesus was going to return? But an angel let them know that Jesus would be coming back. But they probably didn't realize it was going to take such a long time. But in the meantime, the disciples were really excited about what Jesus had to say. They went to the church and they spoke about him and they talked to their friends and they ran around and they were excited because Jesus was the Messiah. And they were all stirred up. And look, they were all stirred up just like our raisins who are still going. They are still dancing. Theo, how do you think you would have felt if you saw Jesus going up into the clouds? That probably would have been a little scary. It might have been shocking or exciting, but we can know that we should be excited to share God's word and Jesus' gospel with everyone. That's why they call gospel good news, because it's exciting. Thanks for your help, Theo. But before we go, let's pray together and then I will send you off to your teachers. Okay, so wiggle your fingers, fold your hands with me, and let's bow our heads together and pray. Dear God, thank you for who you are. Thank you for resurrection joy, and thank you for your love. Thank you for Jesus. In his name, amen. Thank you, kids, for hanging out with me. So you can go to your parents and say, hey, I learned a new word. And it's called ascension, and it's like an elevator. Exactly. See, I knew you're such a smarty pants. Okay, see you next week. Bye.